In this video, I'll explain how you can start your examination on My Perfectis portal. So the very first thing you have to do is you have to open the Chrome browser. If you wish, you can start with the Firefox as well. The steps are similar. And then you have to visit this website, eproctor.myperfectis.com. Press enter. Then on the top right corner, you'll find an option to login. Click on login button. And then you have to enter your credential here, your registration number. In your case, it will be registration number of yours, and then a password which will be shared through email ID, your email ID or my message on UMS. So please check your UMS for the password or email as well. So use your registration number in the very first box, and in the second box use the password which has been shared. Then click on login button. Once you log in, you'll be moved to test tab, and the very first test which is available for me is demo practice test. In your case, it will be the name of the course code for which the examination is scheduled. Now to start the test, I'm going to click on the name of the test. So in my case, the name of the test is demo practice test. And I can do that by two way, by clicking either on demo practice test or view. So I'm going to click on the name of the test itself. And you can see the moment I'll be moved to the new page, I'll be prompted to allow the camera to be used by this portal. So I have got two options, allow and block. I'm going to click on allow. And you can see now my face is visible in the camera. That means camera is working and the portal has got the access to use the camera. Now, just in case you want to change this setting, or let us say you are not getting this option to allow and you are not able to move to the next page, you can always click on this lock icon and you can see the camera is allowed here. Or you can alternatively go to the site setting. And location has not been asked, so I'm going to allow the location as well and microphone as well. As long as camera is allowed, these two won't make any difference. But just to be safe, make sure these three options are allowed: location, camera and microphone. Once these three are allowed, close this window, and now you'll see you have got an option to reload the page to apply the setting that you have just made. So I'm going to click on reload. And now you can see the camera is still detecting my face. And now if I'll click here, you can see the portal is using the location, camera and microphone. All these three options are allowed now. Now I'll click on the tech test. And once I'll click, I'll be moved to the instruction page. Now this instruction area, this is the area where you'll get the instruction, and this is the area where you'll get instruction from the university side. There are some generic instruction by the portal itself which is given here. So in this case it is not required, or if you wish you can read these as well. Most of them are not applicable to you, so I would strictly encourage you to use the instruction mentioned here. And these instructions are specific to the examination. So some of the points mentioned here will be applicable to all the examination that you'll go through, and some of the points or instruction that has been mentioned here will be applicable to this exam as well. So although you are using your third, fourth or fifth paper, make sure you read all the points, because it may have some valuable information for you. Now in this case, the very first instruction is that make sure you have enough data to complete the test, and find yourself a destruction-free area to attempt the test. Keep at least 10-12 blank A4 sheets. Now these are all instruction, and it is supposed to be changed in coming days. Now here is an example how you can use an A4 sheet to write your answer for a particular question. So this is the format that you have to follow. Now once I'm done reading all these A4 sheets, I'm going to click on I'm ready to start. And you won't be able to start the test unless the actual time set for the examination has been crossed. Okay, so therefore, if it is 11:30 and the test is scheduled to happen at 12, you won't be able to start the test. Now, before we move forward, let's discuss total exam duration breakup. So we have got total 3 questions per exam, and to solve each question, we have got 30 minutes, and we have got 10 minutes to upload answer for the same. So in a way, if you look, we have got in total 40 minutes to answer a question, which includes writing and uploading as well. And since we have got 3 questions, so total becomes 120 minutes. So that is how you have been given 120 minutes for the examination. So I'm going to summarize again. We have got 3 questions. For each question, we have got 30 minutes to solve, 10 minutes to upload, and therefore we have got 40 minutes in total for each question. And we have got 3 questions, so therefore 40 into 3 becomes 120 minutes, which is the total exam duration which has been given to you. Alright, now this is up to you how you want to utilize this 30 plus 10 breakup. And if you want, you can attempt the question in 25 minutes, you can use 15 minutes for the uploading. So that is up to you entirely. Now let's move to the examination interface. Now you can see I'm on the very first question. On the top right corner, you can see I have got a reverse timer. That means I'm left with 119 minutes. That means the total duration for this exam is 2 hours. I've got a finish button. I can click on this button anytime to finish the test. This is the question area where I'm looking at the question, and the question says that discuss the working of centrifugal pump with all the details. This is question number 1. Then I've got 4 options here at the bottom and 1 option here. And you can see the camera view on the top right corner. This is the calculator. Just in case you require calculator to calculate something, you can always click on this calculator button. And there are some. This is a nice calculator to use. Okay. Now, take picture is applicable when you want to take snapshot of answer sheet through the webcam. But the quality of that picture is always going to be low. So we highly encourage you to take picture through your mobile and then upload it using the second option called upload picture. The third option is upload documents. Just in case if you have PDF for your answer, you can always use this option to upload the answer. So I have already created an answer for this particular question. What you can do is you can click on this upload picture button. A new dialog box will appear, and using this option here, you can always go to any location you want. So my pictures are uploaded locally on this picture folder on my PC. Here it is. Now, in some cases, you might be clicking the picture through your mobile and then transferring it to PC, or you can be downloading, you can be directly uploading the picture from your device itself. Now, that option will be shown in the picture question number 2. For now, I'm showing how you can upload the picture. And in the next question, you'll see how I'll upload the question from the mobile itself after clicking. So for now, I'm going to use this image. Question was page 1 as the first answer. I'll select this, click open. I'll wait for the file to be uploaded. And I can see the file has been uploaded successfully. I'll give it some time before it loads the preview of the same image. Just give it some time. Now you can see it is showing me the preview of the image that I have uploaded. So this is the very first image as my answer. Now I'm going at the bottom of the page, click on upload picture again, and then I'll select question number 1, page 2. So this is the second page of the same answer. So I'm going to select this, click open. Now again it is uploading. I'll give it some time. And now you can see that the second file is uploaded. And once the preview of the first file will be completed, you'll be able to see the preview of the second image as well. Now you can see the preview of the second image is being loaded. Now let's discuss what information do you need to mention on your A4 sheet answer sheet. On the very top of the page, you need to input these three information: registration number, whatever your registration number should be mentioned here, the exam time, the question number that you are solving on from the portal. So this is question number one. Exam date. So I'm assuming today is 25th of June 2020, and you can write the date you are attempting your paper on, course code of the paper, and the page number. So this is the very first page of my answer. So this is going to be page 1 of 4. And then I'm going to draw a line. I'm going to write my question. So I have basically copied down from the portal itself here. And then from this point onward, I'm writing my answer. And you can write answer text as well. If you want, you can draw something anywhere on the answer sheet. At the bottom, you have to mention your signature. And in the second page, the information at the top of the page needs to be same, except this page number. Now the page, this page number has become 2 of 4, because this is the second page. And this 4 represents that we are totally accepting 4 images at max for any particular question. So this is the second page of 4 maximum pages possible. If you'll upload the fifth one, the chances are it is not going to be evaluated. So try to keep your answer on the only 4 pages at itself. And in the second page, you can see we have got a line, but there is no question. So the answer is being continued from the first page itself. So that means from this point, after drawing the image, I'm continuing with my answer. Once you'll finish the answer, please make sure to include this tag, end of answer, so that evaluator can understand. At this point, you have finished your answer. And if you looked into this image, you'll find there are some text written in black color, some of them is written in blue color. That means I lost the ink of my pen. And therefore, you're highly encouraged to keep at least multiple pen before starting the exam, so that you do not run into such trouble. And once I have uploaded these two images, I can always go to the bottom of the page, and now I can click next. So when you click next, it will ask you to go to the full screen. So click OK. Now you're on the full screen. Click next, and then you'll be prompted to a warning that you would not be able to return to this question and change answer or attachment. Do you want to move to the next question? So I'm pretty sure that I have done answering this question and I do not need to review this later on. So I'll click yes. So when you click yes, you'll be moved to the next question. Now I'm going to show you how you can transfer your image from the mobile phone to the laptop itself. Now write your question. Write your answer on the A4 sheet, and then take out the mobile, start your camera, point it to the answer sheet, take a snap, go to the other page, click the photograph of second one, and then connect your mobile phone through the data cable. So I'm going to connect my mobile phone using the data cable. I'm going to minimize the camera app now. I have connected my mobile phone. I'll go to the notification menu and I'll allow my device to transfer file. I'll go back, and now I'll go back to the laptop, click on upload picture, and now go to PC, and now my device is visible here. Click on internal shared storage, and the image is generally stored in this folder DCIM. So I'm going to click on this. I'm going to click on camera, and once I'm done, it's very difficult to find the image, but what I can do is I can use this more option menu. I can go to details, detail view, and under this modified column, I can click one time to store the image in the newest image first and the oldest image last. So you can see these are the three images that has been clicked. And right now the time is 2:31 p.m. and this image has been clicked at 2:29 p.m. So these two images are same. I mistakenly I clicked two times for the last page. So I'm going to delete this. And this image was captured first. So I'm going to select this image. And then I'm going to click open. Now you can see it will start uploading. Now, here is one point. If you are using the main camera of your phone and your phone main camera is of high resolution, the size of image is supposed to be larger one. So what I would recommend is, please make sure that the setting of your camera is medium. Okay, image quality is medium. So I'll wait for the file to be uploaded, because if you'll keep the image size or image quality higher, the size of the image will be bigger and it will be difficult to upload the image. So keep the resolution medium. And that is the problem I'm facing here. The size of the image is too big, around 5 MB. So I'll wait because I don't have any other option. And now you can see the file is uploaded. And most probably I should view the preview as well. So you can see this is pretty much readable. Okay, and this is the very first image. And my answer contains two images. So I'll have to do repeat the same activity again. I'll click on upload picture. And then again, I'll go to the device name. Open this. Go to DCIM folder. Camera. And this setting is still there. This is the last picture that has been captured. That means 7th of June 2020 at 2:29 p.m. If you are not going to see this, click on this modified column and you will be able to see the last for clicked file at the top. So this is the second last file that I have clicked. So I'll select this and I'll click open. And now you can see the file is being uploaded. So I'll wait for the file to be uploaded. Now I can see the confirmation of the second image to be uploaded. Now I'll go to the bottom and you can see now the second image is being previewed here. So you got the idea how to transfer image from the mobile to the laptop. And as I was saying, that keep your image quality to the mediums by going to your camera app, so that when you click on the picture, the size of the picture remains of a little bit on smaller size. Now, if you try to move your cursor out of this examination window, you will see a warning. Just have a look. I'm going out of the exam window, and when I'll come back, you'll see a warning. Now, this warning is not being counted because this is a demo account. But when you'll attempt the same test in your paper, this will be counted as a warning. So I'll highly encourage you not to move away from this exam window, which is in this blue color, okay? Even if you'll go to the scroll bar, have a look. Scroll bar is not being detected, so that is good. You can use the scroll. And now I'm going to click on next, and you can see it is asking me to go to full screen. I'll go to next. And again, it is asking that if you'll go to the next question, you won't be able to come back. So that is fine, because I have done already. I have answered the question already. Click on yes. And I do not want to answer this question. It seems a little bit difficult to me. Even the previous question I answered differently. When you're writing the answer, make sure your handwriting is readable because your paper is not being presented to the evaluator. Evaluator will be evaluating the image itself. So the chances of image clarity to deteriorate is a little bit higher. So keep your writing a little bit good. Now I'm going to click on this finish test. Yes, I want to finish. And that means, and now you can see that I have got a notification that my test has been submitted successfully. Okay, so this is how you attempt test on this portal.